today. From TIAA Bank Field in Jacksonville, Florida, this is Madden Football on EA Sports. Jacksonville Jaguars taking on Ryan Fitzpatrick and the Miami Dolphins.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State and TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. A few minutes prior to us coming on air, this crowd was jolted into action with the introduction of these Jaguars. They're set for football as the Jags are ready to match up with the Miami Dolphins. Brandon Gunn with Charles Davis. And Charles, we got two teams here that finished at the bottom of the standings last year. But remember this, 15 of the last 16 seasons, we've seen at least one team go from the bottom of their division to the top in one season.
Last year we had two, Chicago and Houston. These two teams playing now, they think they can do the exact same thing this year and make it 16 out of 17 seasons.
Jason Sanders.
Two teams on opposite ends of the Sunshine State. The Jags and Dolphins are underway. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
The Jaguars take
out come the Jaguars, and it's Gardner Minshew, their second-year quarterback, leading the way.
I know that people like him, and he's kind of a phenomenon in the league as Gardner Minshew, but I'm not sure he gets enough credit for how well he plays the game of football at the quarterback spot. Remember, he was a sixth-round pick, and a surprise sixth-round pick at that. More than held his own as a rookie after Nick Foles' broken clavicle. Forced him onto the field in the second quarter of week one. The Jaguars went 6-6 with him as a starter in 12 opportunities. Now they've got a chance to continue to progress and move forward with Gardner Minshew leading their team.
Throwing on first down is Minshew. And he completes it to Westbrook. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
Well, when the Jaguars wanted to throw the football, they often looked at D.D. Westbrook, who just completed that play there. 101 targets, 66 catches for both 2018 and 2019.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. First carry for Raquel Armstead. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
Well, that was not what you would call straight line pursuit for a middle linebacker to make this play. He's got to work his way through the clutter to get to the ball carrier on the outside, and he does exactly that. That's called avoiding the trash.
Third play here, this opening drive as they're up against a third and five. Out of the gun is Minshew. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. Jakeem Grant back deep for Miami. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And it'll be Dolphin football. The Dolphins set to go now, and their veteran quarterback leading him onto the field. He's played a lot of places, Ryan Fitzpatrick.
Ryan Fitzpatrick is the kind of guy you want on your team in every situation, whether you want him to be your starter, whether you want him to bridge and help a rookie out like Tua Tagovailoa. It doesn't matter. He can fit every spot you're looking for. He's in the second year of a two-year deal, went 5-8 and 13 starts last year with 20 touchdown passes. And anytime he's on the field, there could be some Fitz magic.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Here's carry number one for Jordan Howard. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Josh Jones in on the stop.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Now Fitzpatrick. Got a man open. That's Devontae Parker complete. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 15 yards on the play. First down.
Nice snag by Devontae Parker. While it took him 5 years in the league to have his first 1,000-yard season, he broke out in a big way. The former first-round pick had career highs across the board in 2019. In fact, his touchdown total for the year equaled his career total to date.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. From the shotgun, it's Fitzpatrick. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over him, and they got there to break that one up.
Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Throwing again, Fitzpatrick. That'll be complete to Breida. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
On third down, Fitzpatrick. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That one good for 13 at a Dolphin first down. No score after one on EA Sports.
No score.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. First down, they run with Howard. And this time, they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is really flowing around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
Second and 12, Fitzpatrick flushed out right. And now he's going to use his legs. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 35. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 35-yard line. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll check in with our Jonathan Coachman. He'll have highlights and analysis of the first half, and our highlights will likely be on the defensive side of the football here. Scoreless game.
Fitzpatrick.
It's a gain of 5, and it'll be second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam coming out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Fitzpatrick throwing complete, and he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars 19. 12 yards there on a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, Fitzpatrick. His throw incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And that'll bring up second down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target. But he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw again, Fitzpatrick. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. They forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Left going to the air on the opening drive. His pass caught at the 4. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half.
Come on down, let's do this!
First and goal from just inside the 5.
Watch his left, watch his left.
To the air again, Fitzpatrick. That'll be caught for a Dolphin touchdown. It's Williams.
Complete to Preston Williams.
4 yards on the touchdown grab. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Jason Sanders now for the extra point. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins. So that one a 13-play drive in total. And it ends with a touchdown for the Dolphins.
Jason Sanders.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Jaguars going back to work. 6-10, the final record in 2019 for them. And you wonder what lies ahead in 2020. A lot of folks predicting a 4th-place finish in the AFC South. So maybe it could be a year where they get in line for one of the top quarterbacks coming out of college. But, you know, of course, Gardner Minshew, he might be saying, hold on just a second now on that talk.
Oh, he's absolutely saying that one, partner, because last year during the draft, the GM called Gardner and told him, hey, we're probably not going to take a quarterback here. And he said, that's fine, because he's just going to have to sit behind me anyway. So he's a very confident young man, and this team responds to him. And they feel like they've gotten better on offense, and they really need Leonard Fournette to really be a pile driver as a running back. But on defense, that's where they really got better. First round pick C.J. Henderson on the corner and Kalavon Chaisson at linebacker and defensive end. They've got a chance to get better in a hurry in a tough division.
And now, Charles, they have lost a few people, kind of dampering the enthusiasm just a bit in Jacksonville.
Yeah, they lost Calais Campbell and A.J. Boye on defense and a young tight end, Josh Oliver. He got hurt in training camp. But they also added a few people, Tim Jernigan to play defensive line and Tyler Eifert to play tight end.
The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. From the gun, Minshew to throw. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Jerome Baker right there in coverage.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. It'll be Minshew again. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. Chris Conley, the intended receiver, and that'll make it third down.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up third and 10. Again, Minshew looking to throw. The open man is Shark. It's complete. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Minshew, first and 10. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. Now Minshew. Forced out to his left. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
Third down.
So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. We saw a strong first half from our quarterback. His guys have the lead as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. In front, and they'll be in possession of the football first as the second half gets started. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
They're on the 24-yard line.
So Miami coming out for their second drive. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. On first and 10, Fitzpatrick. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
A second and 10 forthcoming here. Third quarter action from Jacksonville. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Well, you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those. But the coverage has been excellent thus far. And it was again on the last play.
10 yards to go.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. That one good for 13 at a Dolphin first down. So they did not bring pressure, and turns out probably a bad idea.
Yeah, he had time to stand in the pocket and deliver a strike. So I'm wondering if they're going to note that, and next time just go ahead and bring that pressure.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll throw again. Fitzpatrick. Throw left side complete. It's Grant. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Gain of 9.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
He winds up giving a yard back there, and now it's third and 2.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Jags have 5 in the secondary here on third down. They'll try to run for it with Howard. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A nice first down pickup on a gain of 6.
Carry there by Jordan Howard. And we all know he started his career in Chicago and was a 2-time 1,000-yard rusher. Spent 2019 in Philadelphia battling injuries. But when he's healthy, can be a flat-out workhorse and can break down defenses.
Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Running with Howard. Takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there. The ball carrier.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Fitzpatrick now from the 50. Got his man. It's Williams. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Jaguars' 34-yard line. That'll be a gain of 15 yards. And the Dolphins are going to get a fresh set of downs. And they will not have time to get another play in here as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Throwing Fitzpatrick. Oh no, he lost the football. Can hear it all the way up here. Those guys down on the field alerting everyone to the fumble. He's lucky that his offensive mates picked him up and jumped on it.
Yeah, and you have to think to yourself, and I'm sure they've been echoing it on the sideline and into the huddle. Guys, we have the lead. Just take care of the football. Don't make it easier for them to start to make a comeback.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Out of the shotgun, Breida. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
He's tackled at the 32-yard line. A gain of 4. And it's third down.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes. And we've got a one-score game. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. He'll get this into the hands of Breida. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. It looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for first and goal. On first and goal, Howard. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. 3 yards to go on second down, and they've got 3 tight ends out there. Jumbo set. Try to punch it in with Howard. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Back at the 6. Not at all what they envisioned on third down. 3 yards in the wrong direction.
But when the ball snapped from the 3 down near the goal line, I think in days gone by, we thought many teams would run the football. But on third down in today's game, I expect them to throw it. A little counterintuitive there. They tried to run it, instead spilled for a loss.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a 2-score game. Sanders' kick is good. And the lead moves to 10-0.
Dolphins 10, Jaguars nothing.
So barring something extraordinary here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Yeah, we've got to find 2 scores. So, you know, we're not going to exactly move it over there yet. It can be done, but, boy, it's going to be a little bit of a stretch for them, isn't it?
Yeah, they would have to move incredibly quick and have some luck, too. After the field goal, here comes Sanders to kick it away. Keelan Cole now to return. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
At their own 26-yard line.
So Minshew and the Jaguars down 10-0, 55 seconds remaining. They've yet to score all game long, but now they need to do so twice in short order to have a shot. Minshew on first and 10. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
Nice play by DJ Chark there, and he's a great example of how a guy can improve from his rookie year to season two. Quiet as a rookie, 1,000-yard season last year, ended up becoming a Pro Bowl selection for the Jaguars.
Now a desperation throw deep, and that's caught inside the 30. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 33 yards that time.
Jam at the 28-yard line.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. This one complete to the tight end, O'Shaughnessy. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4. So a victory here for the Miami Dolphins. And not all W's are created equal, CD, and this one came in shutout fashion.
Well, their offense certainly didn't need to do anything, right? They could take the day off, and they did. But the defense, they carried them in a big way.
Yeah, look, the offense obviously stuff to work on, but they did enough, and the defense carried the load.
But you know what they say, it's always fun to work on things if it didn't go well in your game with a victory in your pocket. And that's what they've got going forward.
For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we sign off from Jacksonville.